reading from Brief, which is due for release in September. In this scene, the lead character, Jem, a paramedic with a daft name, terrible luck and chronic asthma, has been sent to a lad pulled from a river in the middle of a wood. Jem's working solo on the rapid response car, and the guy who's guided her to the patient is a homeless chap called Bear. That's pretty much all you need to know. I need help out here, Jem shouted into her radio. This lad's about to arrest and I can't move him on my own. Police are en route, her dispatcher said. No ETA. Thank fuck for that, she muttered. Then, louder, cheers, better than nothing. She reached for the suction as the lad gagged and coughed, sending a thick spray of blood and vomit across her shirt. Shh, it's all right, she said. You're all right, you're a paramedic, no one's going to hurt you. A thin wail sent goose pimples rippling across her skin, and for an irrational moment she thought he might wake, until the noise cut off as if a switch had been hit, his hands falling limp, his body tensing and then relaxing. She watched, horrified, as 8 breaths became 5, then 2, then stopped altogether. Shit. She looked at the monitor, its screen now showing an irregular mass of rapid spikes. Bear, move, get clear. She hit charge on the defib as Bear stared, open-mouthed. The shock she administered made the lad's limbs jerk in unison and turned the spikes into an ominous flat line. She immediately started CPR, counting out the rate as she pushed on his bony chest. 30 compressions to 2 breaths. She repeated the cycle without pause, willing the monitor to show even the slightest sign of recovery, but there was nothing except the beat she created. Time passed by in a blur of pumping first his chest and then the ventilation bag. The exertion stopped her from feeling the cold, but she could feel the muscles in her arms beginning to shake, and she knew she had to rest. Bear, can you help me? Here, like this. She positioned his hands and started the metronome on the monitor. This will keep you to a rhythm. Don't push too hard. That's perfect. Holding the torch in her mouth, she dragged her bag closer and found the IV pouch. She tried for the external jugular vein, letting out a short gasp of surprise when she hit it first time. Adrenaline's in, she said, marking the time on her glove. Ben nodded as if he understood and then cocked his head to one side. I can hear someone shouting, he said. Shall I go and fetch him? Yes, go, I've got this. She readied her hands again, swapping roles smoothly as he scrambled to his feet. Won't be long, miss. He quickly vanished from sight, swallowed up by the fog swirling off the lake. The metronome continued to tick, its measured beat a stark contrast to the frantic pounding of her pulse. 30 to 2, over and over, even though she knew it was hopeless, that it had already been too long, and nothing she could do for the lad would fix him. 30 to 2, 30 to 2. Biting down on her lip, she bowed her head and persevered.